It's not always easy to create a great GUI using a service. It's even more difficult in an embedded environment that doesn't have enough resources. There's a display that approaches in a different way, so I'd like to show you how it works. Here is a 7-inch display. This is a coffee machine UI that I made myself, referring to the coffee machine display currently on the market. It's working very well with IPS panel and capacitive touch panel. Unlike the display I have used so far, it works independently as a device. A typical device for MCU was able to write a code based on the graphics library to display images on the screen or receive input from users. In this display, you can draw the display part first using UI tool and connecting MCU such as Arduino or ESP32 via UART communication. This is a short video that deals with the basic UI tool from the product unboxing. Let's get started. This is CloudWise's ATFC touchscreen 7-inch product. I'm not sure, but this company seems like a startup company. I never heard about this company. Anyway, the box contains a USB cable, a 7-inch display, and 4-pin connector. It's a very simple package. This product has a resolution of 1024 by 600 and is an IPS panel. It's including a capacitive touch panel too. If you look at the left end, there is a pinout for speaker connection. It also contains a battery to maintain a system time. It's equipped with an ARM CPU and operates at 600 MHz. It's very good in terms of performance. There is always storage of resources in an embedded environment, but this product has 128 GB of flash memory, which can contain many graphical resources. It's very fantastic. Also, it has 2 pins for UART communication with MCU. As long as RX and TX can be connected, it can be used in any MCU. There is a switch to change the device mode. In USB mode, you can easily put the UI file you make. In work mode, it reads your UI file and display directly on the screen. We simply create a part of GUI and the rest is being handled by the built-in system. It works in a very simple way, so it's easy to use. I will try to power up the product. This is work mode and the demo UI works. The company logo comes up first and I see a widget that I can get some input from. Tap the field and you'll see the keyboard. Because the display is big, typing can be done smoothly. It works very well without any input delay. Entering a number this time, the number pad works very well too. I typed 20 and the gauge bar of 20 went up. The value changes on the right as you adjust the progress bar. Bar interaction is no longer possible if the switch below is off. The next screen shows a more interesting screen using a progress bar. The gauge image moves according to the value. The quality is good. Next, there is a screen to draw the graph with the values from the MCU. I haven't connected to any MCU yet, so I don't have anything to do here. Let me go to the next screen. You can swipe to move on to the next screen. Play the video button and play the music button are placed here. I need to get an event callback from the MCU and then play the video. Since I didn't connect anything, I just send a message through a serial to play the video file. And the video is playing. It supports AVI in MJPEG format. I think we can make a high quality UI with this. Personally, I like this because I can play the video in an embedded environment. The speaker is not connected, so the audio is skipped. This is all about the built-in demo. Let me tell you about the UI tool that this company supports briefly. It can be downloaded from this company's website and only supports Windows. This software is not that difficult, so you can create UI intuitively. Of course, there may be a difference, but I think you can make the screen you want if you handle it for a day or two. It supports various image files, BMP, JPEG, PNG, to easily create the UI you want. You can create a screen for each page, determine the effect of moving the screen, and set up events for buttons. If you need more information, please visit this company's site. There are videos about how to use UI tool in detail, and you can get a couple of example projects. When you save the UI you worked on as a file, it saves one file with the extension ERS. It says that the device can have only one ERS file. If you copy and insert this file into the device, it will operate on its own. It's very simple. The pros and cons of this product are pretty stubborn. The advantage is that the user interface works independently, so the performance is excellent. If Arduino or ESP32 were to handle everything, it would be very slow to redraw the screen and RAG resources. Because there is a 128 MB of user-friendly space, I don't think there will be a shortage of resources when working on a project. The UI drawing tool is provided, so you can easily create the UI. Also, it'll be great for creating demo products such as Kiosk, because you can play multimedia files. The disadvantage is that it has only UART communication with the MCU. To update the display from the MCU, you command it via serial. All events in the display can be obtained through the callback functions. It's like dealing with two independent devices. Also, with UART, it seems almost impossible to send data from MCU to display vice versa. If there is a module like HDMI, it will be possible to use it more diversely. This display is the type I haven't seen so far. I don't know what I'm gonna make with this yet, but it must be an interesting device. If I have a good idea, I will go a new project with this display. That's all for today's video. Thanks for watching. See you on the next video.